Hey guys, what's going on? Today we are here for essentially a video that's going over the new Dokkan Fest banners that are coming out over the next few days and whether you should actually summon on them or not. There's a little bit of controversy on it. A lot of people are saying don't summon on them, that they're crap banners or garbage banners. And for the most part, that is true. So if you want my honest answer, unless you are a brand new player, there's really no reason for you to summon on them. We're going to go and talk about the banners and if you do want to summon on, which ones will probably be the best ones. So let's go ahead and jump into that. But before we do, I did want to say the tournament distribution has come and I was lucky enough to place. I got in the top 10,000, so I got my Trunks. I have him maxed out level 100 right now. I'm waiting to see if he gets a Dokkan. When he gets a Dokkan Awakening on the JP side. Personally, I think the guy's going to get like key plus 3, attack plus 90% on his passive, but you never know. He can keep his current key boost and then get like attack plus 100 or something like that. But we'll have to wait and see what happens. I am just very happy that I did place. So I have that. Plus, there was maintenance last night for the global side. We're going to talk a little bit about that. That has ended. We have all the information about the cards, obviously what you guys were all thinking. The free-to-play Kale Khalifa, the Dokkan Awakens for Kale Khalifa, the Godku, Dokkans, Jiren. We had a whole bunch of stuff. We're going to talk about that. We'll touch upon that in a little bit. But really, we're going to mainly focus on this Dokkan Festival banners that are currently out. Well, actually, the physical one's currently out, but every couple days we're getting a new one. So this is the one that's currently out right now. This is the physical Dokkan Fest. It features the 70% leader Broly, the full power Frieza, and the Kid Buu. Now, I did touch upon them when the data download came out and what you should do, what you shouldn't do a little bit. Personally, I don't really think that the Broly is that fantastic. I know a lot of you say that he's a good unit and that he's awesome. And you know what? Yeah, if you 100% this guy, or you don't even need to 100% him, if you just give him crits, give him the full top left bottom right do pass. He is a very good unit. He only does supreme damage, but with his guaranteed additional super, when you get key 10 or more, he is really good. I actually think it's 9 or more when you Dokkan him. But at the same time, he doesn't really have a lot of people that fit with him on the mono extreme tech team. If you have the LR Broly, that LR Broly takes his place. And I mean, the OG Broly also is a hell of a lot better in terms of units to run. So unless you're going up against an agility team or an agility opponent, there's really no reason for you to have him. I just personally don't think the physical Broly is really that worth it out of all the Brolys in the game. But you know what? That's just my opinion on the matter. He is there. If you don't have him and you really like Broly, maybe you can go for him. I personally don't. I wouldn't do it, but I don't really think this is the best banner. The Kid Buu is awesome when he Dokkan Awakens. He is a very good support unit, but your HP has to pretty much be 100% all the time. You can take a little bit of damage, but the minute you go below 80% health, it's all over, and that amazing buff that you get when he Dokkan Awakens is gone. Full Power Frieza is probably the only one on this banner that's really useful, but you get a red stone a lot, and you could probably just buy him. You know what I mean? Like, you not even buy him, it's like, well, technically buy him. Not cash monetary value, red stone monetary value. That's what I'm thinking, though. It is a guaranteed featured SSR. There's only 3 of them, so you have a 33% chance to get the one that you want if you want to go on this banner. But out of all of them, honestly, I'm going to tell you guys straight up my opinion on the matter is that this is the least enticing banner out of the 5 Dokkan Fest banners that are going to be available for us. So if you're looking for a banner out of these 5 to go on, this is definitely not the one. Now, shout out to DBZ.space if I haven't done that. Shout out to the Reddit and shout out to Krusty Leaks. For all this information, this great stuff. In terms of Krusty Leaks, this is going to be the other stuff. I mean, we have the JP side. I have all the JP information over here as well. I just like the Krusty Leaks. It's a little bit bigger, I guess, for the screen. So we have the Omega Shenron banner that is also going to be coming. It's Omega Shenron, the OG Broly, and the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta. Now, personally, I think that this is a very enticing banner because all 3 of these guys are still relevant. Yes, the Omega Shenron has been replaced by the physical variant if you happen to have him, but on a mono strength team, he is still very viable. He's still a really good unit, and I mean, personally, it really depends on what you're trying to run. He does immense damage, he does a lot of damage, and the damage reduction that he does for everyone on the field, I still think that he's a very good unit, and he will have some places over the physical Omega, depending on the type of event you go up against. The OG Broly has an Extreme Z Awakening as of right now. On the global side, I still think he's very good, especially if you don't have a good AoE. And by good AoE, I mean LR Broly, because that's really the only other really good AoE for a World Tournament, unless you plan on feeding in the Tech Majin Vegeta, or if you have the LR Majin Vegeta. I mean, there are other things, though. I know when you 100% the free-to-play Raditz, he's still viable for the World Tournament, especially if you have a Nuker leader. But overall, I think that the Broly's better, especially when he gets his Extreme Z Awakening. Plus, he's the only Broly that has a defensive buff, which definitely makes him a lot more viable than the other Broly's. And the Vegeta over here, he's just a staple. He fits on the Super Saiyan 3 team, which will be coming out shortly, hopefully soon. I really want that Bardock. He does damage reduction for like 80% for like 5 turns or something like that. He is a staple in so many events because of that damage reduction. He tanks everything. He's essentially like Golden Frieza without the HP restriction, just a turn restriction. So, personally, I think he's awesome. All three of these units are viable. All three of these units are great. The OG Broly is only really still viable if you are able to get the Extreme Z Awaken on him. But even once you do that, this is a very good banner. I know a lot of you who are probably saying, no, don't do it. But that, honestly, at the end of the day, if you're looking for good units to run on your primary teams, all three of these guys are very good. In terms of the Buhan banner, the Buhan, Janemba, and Vegeta, all three of these guys still very good, very unique units. Now, unfortunately, Buhan's only good on his mono team. There is no other Buhan, which is a good thing, which means you can run Buhan on a villain's team if you want to. He links very, very well with the Kid Buu, the 120 lead. Unfortunately for him, the 120 Kid Buu is almost never run. You need to specifically go out looking for Kid Buu friends when you're trying to run Buhan, and that goes for Janemba as well. Buhan and Janemba are both staples in Mono Extreme teams, Mono Extreme Intelligence specifically. Now, the Janemba does have a replacement, his 120 counterpart, which does have an attack buff. So if you're looking to run on a Mono Villains team and you have the Strength one, chances are you're going to run the Strength one over the Intelligence one, only because the Strength one does it more damage. But for a Mono Intelligence team, those two units are staples for that team, unless you have like an LR Bojack, and then it really depends on which one you have 100% it, because both of them are still very good. The Vegeta for a Mono Intelligence team, hero team, he's still a good staple in that team. He's definitely an S tier unit. There are maybe some other units you will want to run over him instead of having him on the team, but he's still a very good unit. He's probably the best Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta characters until the Agility one comes out. So keep that in mind, that he's still a very prevalent card in the game. So all three of these guys are still very good. I would still put this below the Omega banner just because Buhan, while he's good, his healing factor doesn't come into play as much anymore because of how much health that you have. Janemba is still more primary, but it's only good specific to that Mono Intelligence team, especially because you have the Strength one that's out. And Vegeta is going to have a replacement for a Mono Hero team. So on a Mono Intelligence Hero team, you have a lot of other units that you can run. So a lot of these guys have replacements. When you go back over and you look at the actual physical one, the Full Power Frieza doesn't have a replacement. The Broly, oh, I'm sorry. that was not what I wanted to say. The Strength one, Omega has a replacement, but the OG Broly and the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta are still very, very viable. Anyway, so let's go over here. The Vegito banner, you have Rose, you have Vegito, and you have Kaioken Blue Goku. Now, the Kaioken Blue Goku, honestly, I'm sorry, unless you guys really, really like him for some reason, he's not a viable unit. He's viable, okay? He does do damage. He's a good, he's good for your team. But the Agility Goku, the Super Saiyan Blue Goku, is a lot better than him. I mean, this guy, while he does increase his defense, he will reduce your health when he launches a super attack, which kind of sucks. And once the Super Saiyan Blue Goku gets his base form, he's already doing equal amount of damage. I believe it was equal amount of damage as the Kaioken Blue Goku. Super Vegito, I don't have to say anything about him. Honestly, if you don't know about him, he is still one of the best units in game, even though he has a replacement. The Agility one still tanks a hell of a lot better. So on a Mono Heroes team, you're honestly probably better off running him if you're looking for damage reduction, just because while the physical one is really good for damage reduction, he's not as good as the Agility one. And the Agility Rose, while the Strength one is there to replace him, if you're looking to, he's still a really good unit as a universal villains leader, because he doesn't have that stipulation like the current Strength Rose has, where you have to have one of every type. If you don't have one good of every attribute type of villain, while it sucks as he doesn't have a 120%, you could still run him as a leader. Plus, he's still a staple on a mono villain agility team. And he can also run on a mono hero agility team. You know what I mean? So he's good on both sides. Though he doesn't get the full buff, he still does a lot of damage. He's still a very good viable unit. So in terms of this banner, 2 out of the 3 units are really good if you're looking to do that. First featured character is guaranteed. Also, some of you had asked me, I know it's a little bit late into it, there are no LRs on these banners. In terms of the tech banner, this one is up in the air. The Gotenks obviously is going to be replaced by the physical one. He is still a staple on his Mono Tech team, but there's really not much difference between him and the physical one. Although the physical one hits better, so the physical one's gonna replace him on most aspects, even on the Super Saiyan 3 team, the Hybrid Saiyan team. So unless you don't have the actual physical one, this is the only time that the technique one's gonna come into play, is with that Mono Technique team. Merge Zamasu, still a staple in a Mono Extreme Technique team. He does link very well with the Agility Rose and good with Goku Black, the physical Goku Black. He is not used as much today that I've seen on teams. He's still very good. He does do a lot of damage output, and the mine's 100%, and I know that. The newer units are obviously outpacing him because he's older in terms of meta. So while he's still doing about 1 million damage, a lot of the units that are out now are still doing like 2-3 million damage when they're launching their attacks. So he's still, while he's good, he is being a little bit outpaced. There is still no replacement for him though, so keep that in mind. The Merge Zamasu is still going to be a staple on that Mono Extreme Villain Tech team, and he could still be used. While he doesn't share the godly power with the new Rose, he's still good for links, especially with Ki on his team. And he's one of the very few tech villains that I would actually consider running on that team, except for maybe the Golden Frieza, which is also on this banner. Now, Golden Frieza is special because he's one of those guys, he tanks everything when HP is 50% or above. So he does have his usefulness. He does come in clutch on the EZA and on pretty much any event that you need to have survivability because he tanks so much. You just need to make sure you have your health over 50%. So in terms of this banner, I would say that all three of these guys can be viable. The thing is, no one really runs a Super Saiyan 3 Broly lead. So unless you have a Rose and you're going to run Zamasu along with him, he's only really good for that team, at least as of right now. The Patara team, he is good as well, especially with Kefla getting her Dokkan Awakening now. He's going to be really good for that team as well. The only other thing I could think of is if you have the LR Merge Zamasu or LR Zamasu and Rose, he's going to be very good staple for running with alongside of them. So overall, I'm going to say that Gotenks has been deranked. Maybe not deranked, but a very lower S tier unit to run on a team just because he's replaced with the physical one. The Tech Golden Frieza, he has his place, but it's very situational. A lot of people will only run him either on the revived Frieza team because they're perfect linking buddies, or on a Mono Technique team. No one really runs him on a Villains team anymore. He's only really there for survivability. So unless you're running a revived Frieza team, he is going to be situational for you. And the Zamasu, again, situational LR Merge Zamasu or a Mono Extreme Technique Broly team, that is, Super Saiyan 3 Broly team, that is. So these guys are really good. All three of these are still staples. You're going to still be using all three of these guys, but I'm going to put them lower rung. I'm probably going to put them alongside of the Buhan banner over here. So those two are probably going to go. So I think that's about it, because the Broly banner, I don't think you guys should go on. So honestly, out of these, I'm probably going to say the Omega banner and the Vegito banner are probably going to be the two that you might want to pull on, just because the Rose and the Vegito are still very good units. Don't get me wrong, the Buhan banner definitely is very good. Remember, this is really just a trap banners, guys, for the most part. Unless you're brand new players, these units were really good in their heyday, but now they're so outdated that most of them are becoming A tier units now. They used to be S tier, now they're going down to A tier. So that's just my opinion on the matter. I mean, let me know what you guys think about it down in the comments below. But if you're going to summon any of them, I'm probably going to put the Omega one up on top over all of them. Again, that's just one person's opinion. You may think something different. But I personally think that these three units have the most viability out of all five of the banners that are coming out, because these three are going to be used more often than not. The Buhan and the Janemba are still staples in their team, but that's very unique situations. The same thing goes for all these three guys. That's very unique situations that you're going to be using these guys. Honestly, the Vegito, the Rose, the Omega, OG Broly, and Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta are really those guys that you're going to use the most. And because you have the most viability out of all the guys on the strength one, you're probably going to want to run them. On top of that, before we go on to the next bit of information, I did want to say there's not a lot of strength villain characters, so you really want to get them while you can. You know what I'm saying? So that's that. But anyway, just to cover a couple of things, this is the data download that happened. We're just going to talk about it real quick. I'm probably going to do a separate video. New cards that came out that are available: the Tech Android 18, the Strength Super Saiyan Blue Goku Dokkan, the Super Saiyan 2 Caulifla Agility 1 Rebirth. She's also, by the way, real quick, she's going to have a card that feeds into her. That's going to be the Strength Super Saiyan 2 Caulifla. Make sure you increase her Super Attack before you Dokkan her. Physical Kale Rebirth, Physical Super Saiyan Kefla Rebirth, becomes Super Saiyan 2. STR SSR Jiren, no Dokkan Awakens coming with him. Tech Super Saiyan Kaba Rebirth. Finally, he gets Super Saiyan 2. He's become a very good free-to-play unit. Intelligence UI Goku Dokken Awakens. Agility Super Saiyan Blue or Super Saiyan God Goku or Godku Dokken Awakens. Strength Godku Dokkans. And then you get the two free-to-play SSR Strength SSJ2 Caulifla and the Intelligence SSJ2 Kale. SSJ2 Intelligence Kale, very good support unit for Universe Survival. But that's it. I'm going to go over these guys in depth, probably in a video for tomorrow. I just want to go over these Dokkan banners with you just so that way you are aware of them. Oh, also yesterday, sorry, shout out to yesterday for you guys. Let me know in the comments below. I forgot to click on the image. There are a lot of other mission rewards here, so make sure you go and do all them. You need 1,500 stamina over the next like 2 weeks or something like that. So make sure you go and use as much stamina as you possibly can. But anyway, guys, that's it. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments below of these five banners. I personally think that the strength one's going to be the only one. If you're going to pull on any of them, the strength one is probably going to be your primary one. And then after that, it's going to be a mix between the agility and the intelligence one. And then the tech. And then last but not least, the physical, which is out now. Anyway, guys, thank you. I'll catch you all in the comments below. Peace.